Hello, today is March 30th, 2020, and welcome to Quick Reviews. Today I'm going to be taking a look at Buffy the Vampire Slayer Season 4 and Angel Season 1. Buffy Season 4. The version I watched was presented in 16:9 and not its original 4:3 aspect ratio. And it's mostly not a problem, but I laughed a lot in a decapitation scene where the head and body are both dropped from above frame, but with the 16:9 you can see the body still has its head attached. Anyways, I like Xander and Willow in this season, and that's about it as far as character development goes. And Harmony. She's in the first half, and her little parts are some of the best that span multiple episodes. Well, retired Giles does give some humorous scenes. In season 1, there were brief moments of pretty bad overdubbing, and in a couple episodes of season 4, it's back, very bad and much more constant. Just awful and confusing. The big bad is not only laughable, but feels like an afterthought. Overall, this season is not good, but there are some episodes I like. I like the Halloween episode, and Hush, and Superstar is one of my favorite episodes of the entire series. I do want to note that I watched this intertwined with Angel Season 1 via an online watch guide. 2 out of 5. Angel Season 1. Again, not shown in its original 4:3 aspect ratio, and it's worse here. Causing problems in many episodes. Cameramen, boom mics, out of frame enemies just hanging out, and all just staying on screen much longer than Buffy's multi-headed death. And for some reason, they left in some 4:3 transitions, even though the rest are 16:9, they don't zoom in or stretch them, obviously out of place. Unlike Buffy, I never really watched Angel growing up, but I'll start out by saying I liked Angel Season 1 better than Buffy Season 4, but that doesn't mean it's great. At times, it's painfully predictable. Its highlights often come from characters temporarily borrowed from Buffy. In fact, the main cast is all originally from Buffy once its third member is swapped out. I like the original third, but the show does flow better with his replacement. Cordelia, one of my favorite Buffy, isn't nearly as good here. The new constant characters are good. Kate, Doyle, some new constant non-main cast characters are oddly introduced in the third to last episode, but then show up in the others as doing favors to Angel. The lack of a constant big bad is carried over from many seasons of Buffy, and it really does make the season finale seem lackluster. But I do want to know where the story goes, maybe after I take a break from both the series. 3 out of 5. Thanks for watching.